speaking now.
I will talk about the Yeri research that you have to present to your friends in Project Day next month. This year, we will do research about the herbs in Thai forest. So we will go to survey the forest next week. It's early October. Okay, so I will start with where we will go to survey. What do you think?
I've been at the Internal National Park in Chiang Mai. Maybe a lot of herbs that we want to study. And there is a great atmosphere. And the important thing, my friend used to go there. He told me a big forest, and there are various types of herbs. And the staff is knowledgeable about herbs. Yeah.
But I think Gangsa National Park is better because it's not far and easy to go there. Just 2 hours from Bangkok. Yes. And I have been there. I think it maybe have many herbs there.
I agree. Chiang Mai is farther than Thaiburi. It takes a lot of cost to travel to Chiang Mai. The budget from university may not be enough. If we can spend less money for the travel expense, we can spend this budget for more useful stuff.
But he said it was true. That saves more than go to Chiang Mai.
I think we should go to Cambodia because from my experience, I think the herb in that area is more durable herb and Korean type of herb.
In my opinion, maybe we should go to Khao Yai Natural Park because there are many beautiful places and there are various plants. So this place is useful for our project.
But I think the Khao Yai Natural Park is maybe not have a herb more than the Gangsa National Park.
Okay, as you talk, I think Gangsa National Park in Thaiburi Province is suitable because it's not so far, about 2 hours from Bangkok, and there are many herbs in the forest, same as others. Well, how long we will stay there?
Just 2 days to go and stay one night, I think so.
Or round trip. I don't think 2 days are enough for us to collect all data. How about 3 days?
I think 3 days is too long because we will pay expensive cost for our supply and guide earning.
I agree. I think 2 days and 1 night is our city spot because if we plan to go to only 1 day is not enough to collect the herb. Or if we go plan to go to go for 3 days is too much for us to do things because we have to carry it tomorrow.
I think so too, because a 1 day trip is not enough for our project. Yes.
Okay, that's true. I agree with 2 days and 1 night. It's not long time and you have enough time to survey and do research. Okay, next. How will we go there? Let's show you idea.
I will drive you there.
Why? As I know you cannot drive.
Oh, I forgot.
I have a suggestion. We should rent a van and share the cost. And we can also carry our thing with our van and then with a more comfortable fabric.
Yes, I agree with Max because van is very safe for us, and if we choose a quality company, we will save when we travel in this trip, but the price are expensive.
In my bill, I want to go by train because there are free tickets around it.
I like your idea, Kai. I love train ride too. But if we go there by train, when we arrive at station, we have to find a way to go to that place by ourselves. If we go by van, like Max said, the driver can take us to the location directly.
What about you, Ern? What do you think?
I think the van is the best way to go there because it's comfortable and the cost is reserved for us.
Okay, well, because of convenience and saving a budget, we will go there by van. Mm. Everyone agree with it, right?
Yes.
Okay. Next topic is so important. I want you to pay attention for this. The 7 things that we must take with us. Choose something that it's necessary.
I have 10 and my 10 is so strong and fit for 6 person. I will bring it for everyone.
I think flashlight is useful because if we have activity in the dark, we can use this for shine in the forest.
Smartphone has flashlight function, so we can use it instantly, and it is easy to bring because we always take our phone with us.
I cannot agree with you about that. If your phone suddenly was running out, what would you do? And then if we will bring power bank with, that it will put too much.
I have a suggestion. As we travel for the forest, I think we should have a map, a compass, a rope, and maybe something that can protect us during the night when we camp.
But I think the map and compass is not useful for our trip because if we go there, we have a guide to bring us in the forest.
And for a kid, it also necessary. In my view, we should bring a camera for capture the herb. And we should bring food or drink, food and drink.
What kind of food that we should bring to the
I think we should take food such as canned food, chocolate, and rice. Bring it would be more appropriate.
In my opinion, canned food sound great, but I don't think rice is okay because we can cook in the forest. We didn't have gas stove or something for cooking.
So I think we can take picnic stove for cooking food. Picnic stove is easy and convenient for cooking food every menu.
I'm afraid that the stove is too pugnacious and heavy. It's hard to carry.
I think we also should bring something that we can put the herb in, like a little box of bag for that matter.
I think so.
Anything else?
I think the sleeping bag is necessary for us at night, but I don't have it. Who has two sleeping bags for me?
Oh, I think I have some spare sleeping bag. I think I can give it to you.
Okay. have this sleeping bag?
Yes.
Yes, I have.
Okay. Finally, I will summarize today's meeting. Okay, we will go to Gangaja National Park in Thedbury Province for 2 days and one night. And we will go to there by van. Because it's inexpensive and fast. Thing that we must take to there is a tent for Bob, a first aid box for Ploy, camera for Thai, food and drink. I will take them for you all.
All other bring a camera to go there, and should I bring a tripod to go there?
Although it's not necessary, but you have to carry.